Hi and welcome back. I know it's been a while since I've posted anything other than my daughter's current science project, but I had a bit of a problem with a Valentine DIY that I had done. My videos uploaded to my computer and then they got lost. So I don't know where they ended up, where they are. It's a mystery. So I had some really cute Valentine's Day DIYs for you guys, but yeah, those, they were actually gifts from my daughter's teachers, so I no longer have them, and I was very sad that I lost that those videos. There were about two. Anyway, moving on to today's video, I had actually done a video showing you this DIY. It's just a DIY of, you know, those cute little decorative glasses that most people are doing, you know, but I wanted, you know, to give it my own color theme, I guess, with gold and black. And I had already videotaped that, and that was part of the videos that got lost in cyberspace or wherever the videos end up. So anyway, all I did was, this is all Dollar Tree products. It is a glass with the sand, the black sand that you can find also at Dollar Tree for a dollar, and it's a good amount that comes in the pack. I think I've used most of mine. I should have a pack somewhere, but I still have some in here, and I just tied it up with a bow because I didn't want it spilling. So all I did was put two bands, one on the top, one on the bottom, just to make it my own color theme, because I want to change my bathroom color theme to gold and black. And I actually picked up this really cute curtain at Burlington. It was on clearance. It was the two panels. It was about 10 something from, I believe, $18 or $20. It's really cute. It's got golden rings around it. So anyway, this was my DIY for this video, but I had already done these. But let me just show you. I did two. Well, because I was going to put, you know, my sample here was, I was going to put my brushes for them to, you know, stay here. That was the purpose of the sand, black and gold. It's really cute. They've just been sitting here. I've been waiting to do the rest of my DIY. And actually, I had purchased this white liner pencil at Dollar Tree as well. It's in LA Colors. It's white for your water, your bottom waterline. And I just wanted to display it. So I picked a bigger jar at, I believe it was at Marshall's. It was either Marshall's or Ross. I already removed the label because, you know, I washed and cleaned it so that I could work with it. And I picked this one up because I thought I wanted to put my brushes. I have two brushes and two combs in my bathroom where, you know, I used to brush my hair. So I don't need a big jar for brushes and combs. I don't have a whole multitude of them. I just have four, you know, small brush, two team flyaways, and the regular detangling brush and two combs. One detangling comb and one kind of like a styling comb with the rat's tail, the pick at the end. So that's where I'm going to place these. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to redo the diamond wrap around the top and the bottom just to match these, just to make it like match, you know, so they look cute. But I will not be putting any of the black sand in here because, well, those are my brushes, and I don't know, I don't think it, you know, I don't think the brushes need to be sturdy sitting in the jar. So I was debating whether I should use the thicker one because it is a bigger jar, So I was thinking maybe I should use the thicker diamond wrap for the top and the bottom. I do want to do it like the other one, because since it's bigger, it just would look awkward if I used the smaller diamond wrap, which I can't find. But let's pretend this is, I don't know, what do you guys think? I'm thinking the larger one, just because it's a larger jar. So I'm gonna go ahead and use this one. Okay, so I'm gonna go ahead and get that done right now. You guys wanna watch? Let me zoom in a little bit. I'm gonna go get some scissors though, because I haven't cut it to size and I don't want it to right there, guys. I'm going back. Should have my scissors. Sorry, I should have been more prepared. I guess I forgot to size it and cut it. What I didn't like about these jars, and I looked through all the ones that were there, is that they have this, it's from when they make it, it's like a air bubble that gets stuck in there, and I cannot stand that. It frustrates me. So I'm kind of glad that the diamond wrap is going to cover that up. Let me just get a paper towel and wipe that off. Okay, guys, I'm going to go ahead and get started. I'm going to go ahead and measure this. I'm going to leave just a tiny, tiny space from the top so that it doesn't look too awkward, because there's a little bit of, if you can see that at the very top, it'll focus. At the very top, you can see like the it sticks up from the top. So if I put it all the way to the rim, all these little threads, I guess, are going to be sticking out. And I don't want that to show. So I'm going to try to keep it just a little bit. Below the rim. So let me cut this to size. This one's going to be a little bit off. But I think this should work. I'm going to use this to measure the bottom one too. I don't think that there's a difference in size. So I'm going to go ahead and measure the second one. Cut that to its size. That way I have them ready to go. So how are you guys tonight? I am okay. I do have my mommy juice. Can't do without it on a Friday night. Cheers to all the mommies out there, hardworking mommies. I do work. I do work part-time. And I also stay home with my baby. I do have a younger child. So a mommy needs cheers after a long week. All right, back to that DIY here. Where did it go? There it goes. Okay. All right, so I've got my hot glue going. I'm going to stick another glue stick in there because this one's running out. Now I have this high temp glue gun. You can use a low temp. I just like the high temp better, although sometimes I burn myself very badly. So let's go ahead and do this. I'm going to start on that air bubble that frustrates me. Just because it frustrates me, no other reason. So I'm going to dab on some of that glue. There. Let's do it on like three of them. Just so that it's got a good beginning there. A good starting point. I'm going to this over a little bit and make sure that I leave that, so the little threads that I told you about don't stick up out of the jar. What is this, a jar or a vase? Vase, vase, tomato, tomato, potato, potato, right? This is, I guess, a vase. Okay, so now I started that right there, and I did leave a little bit of room so that the threading is not sticking above the jar. It's actually lined up with the jar, so that'll help keep it from fraying, because so much rubbing maybe from the top once you start using it. So I go ahead and glue all around. I'm gonna lay it down. Can you guys see that? No, you can't. Move it up there. I'm gonna lay it down just to put some glue in specific areas and to keep it in line with the other parts that I already glued. It's pretty simple DIY. I am going to be redecorating my bathroom. It has been my goal for a while now. I've been slowly collecting the things as I find them, because I don't know, I'm very picky, I guess, of how things will combine and how it will look. And I just wanted it to look nice. And I've been having a hard time finding a black valance, because I wanted to put like the shower curtain in the back and then like the actual curtain up ahead, up in the front, but tied back so that, you know, it gives it that pop, the color pop of gold. And I love that shower. I should show it to you guys. That shower curtain with the rings on it. It is so pretty. That way you guys get an idea of what I'm talking about. It is so pretty. And I was so lucky I found it. It was in the clearance aisle for about $10 and some change. So with tax, it was a little over, let's see, $11, $12. Well, compared to the $20 it would have originally cost. It is a heavy curtain though, so I am going to get a separate rod for it to hang it up, because, well, you know, you don't want, well, you can't even put too many curtains on one rod anyway, because this one's a regular curtain, a window curtain versus a shower curtain. And the shower curtain, I'm looking for a plain black one. I do know I've seen one at Walmart. I've seen one at, I think it was Bed Bath & Beyond, but my gosh, the price difference is ridiculous. I mean, who's gonna pay 40 bucks for a black, plain black shower curtain? I could understand one with designs and all that, but a plain black shower curtain, $40 at Bath & Body Works is ridiculous. Bath & Body Works, Bed Bath & Beyond. I always confuse those two. I don't know if that happens to you guys. Okay, so now I've got that first one on there. Yay! I think it looks nice. What do you guys think? Does it look good? So now I'm going to do the bottom part just so that it matches the other one. I think it's going to be a nice little set that I'm creating here with the gold and black. And I have another assignment, basically, that my daughter's teacher needs me to do, make a costume of like the Muses and Hercules, the dancing ones. So I was thinking about recording that, because I picked up two plain white dresses at the Goodwills. I found some at the Goodwills. They're women's sizes, but I need to shrink them down to my daughter's. And I purposely did buy women's sizes because it gives me more material to work with. So I was thinking, I wonder if, you know, they would be interested in seeing how I do that or not. But, you know, that would be a whole video in itself. A whole different video. So this one I'm not going to put all the way at the bottom. I'm leaving a big gap from the bottom. So I hope I don't burn myself. I burned myself doing the emoji party stuff that I did. I really severely burned my finger because I was trying to catch the glue gun as it fell down while I was trying to glue, and I touched the tip, which is extremely hot, and that was not a good idea. I guess it was just a reaction, not because I meant to do that. It was just a, you know, like if somebody's falling, you immediately reach out and we'll probably yank them by the hair or grab them by the shirt, and you know, you don't realize that you might expose them or something. So in this case, I burned myself trying to catch the glue gun, and yeah, I ended up burning myself pretty badly, and my skin fell off and everything. It was just a bad decision on my part. So anyway, I'm gonna keep gluing these, and I'm so excited to get my new decorations in my bathroom. I haven't done it simply because I haven't had time, because I mean, I would do work part-time, so it's sometimes I have a busy week, sometimes I don't, and I myself haven't been like 100% happy, joy, you know, because I have some chronic illnesses, and they bring you so down, they make you feel so exhausted. So, oh my gosh, please tell me that I cut it. Oh my gosh, it looks like the bottom one actually was thicker than the top one. Or maybe I went... I just got another strip and I'll glue it on there, so... Good thing is that these you can cut strip by strip and it won't matter. So these last few I'm gonna really glue on there so they stick. Oh. Well, I'll be darned. So this is what it's, you know, gonna look like at the end, and then I'll just put my brush and my combs in there. I'm gonna just clean it off, of course, before I use it. So that I'll have my little set. So I have that little spot right there where I need to fill in. So I'm gonna cut off one piece that I'm gonna glue in there. What did I do? My scissors. So this is gonna have to be extremely secured in there because it's just one. Make sure I get plenty of glue in there. Let me just glue this last piece here. I should have given it more give before I cut it. That's all right though. You always put the seam up towards the back so that nobody will see it or notice it. And this is exactly how I burned myself, doing a tiny piece on that project, and I burned my finger. So y'all be careful working with those hot glue guns. They really are hot. I don't call them hot for nothing. And that one little one. Oh my god, I think I put too much. Well, it'll be extra secure in there. And there you have it. There you have it. This will be my brush and comb. My brush and comb container where I'm going to put it. Just so that it matches my decor. I love the gold and black theme. I love how these look, the gold and black. I know maybe on camera it looks silver, but it is the gold. Let me hold up a silver one so you could see the difference in color, so you can tell it's gold. So I love that gold and black theme. Let me run over there and show you my curtain real quick. That way you have an idea. So I'm gonna leave you here and just, cheers, have a drink. I'll be back. Well, sorry guys. Anyway, I don't have editing software at this point. I've tried three different ones on my Android. I have Android. I don't have Apple or iPhones. I do have Android phone and Android tablet. I have yet to find a good editing app or a good editing software for the computer. I use a laptop. If you guys have any suggestions, please leave it down there. So this is the curtain that I found, and I'm going to place this in front of my black shower curtain. I thought that the design was so cute, and like I said, these are regular curtains that you would hang on your window, but I thought they were so pretty, and I'm just going to use them to decorate the front of my shower. So it looks like this. I don't know if the lighting is making it look awkward, but this is what it looks like. It's gold rings. I'm kind of like a beige background, So I picked this up at, Burlington Coat Factory, if you have a Burlington. Sometimes you find some awesome stuff in their clearance section. And I had actually found a different one that was like, it just had gold polka dots. It was just gold, like barely visible polka dots. But it looked good, but when I saw this one, I'm like, oh my gosh, that gold really stands out. So these are two window panels, and here's a picture. Let's see if you can get it with the price right there. This is what they would look like on your window. Really pretty gold design. Very pretty cool design. So I'm gonna have them exactly like this in my shower. The black shower curtain will be back here, and except these are gonna be tied back this way. I'm thinking of getting magnet ties because I can't drill holes on the walls, being that I'm renting. So I think it's a good deal for, what is it, $10.99? It's $11 for. And these are very, very heavy, and they're very thick. So I guess at one point, if I ever wanted to use them for my actual windows, they're really nice. So that brings us to a close on my DIY for today. I hope you enjoyed it. I enjoy speaking to you guys. Maybe one of these days I can do like a follow me at Dollar Tree. Or, not follow me, come with me to Dollar Tree, or come with me to, there's a store that I like to go to. It's called, oh my gosh, I forgot the name. It's called Factory to You, or if I ask about this. And sometimes you find good things there too. I had purchased these as well, but I didn't know what to do with these. I was thinking maybe I could do the same and just use it for like Q-tips or cotton, and I had bought two of these, and I originally was going to use these, but I thought they were, the top mouth was too wide for me, for my liking. But then I looked at them and I'm like, hey, you know what, I could still use them, maybe even use them just for candles, to put candles in my bathroom, so my bathroom smells nice. Alrighty then, it was a pleasure having you guys again, and might do another DIY, and like I said, there was these dresses that I picked up for my daughter's costume that she has to do. I would have to cut off the top because it comes with these, it's actually a period dress, but I cut off the top, just make it like a tube, and then I have to tighten this to make it and make a slit. I have another one too that she preferred, which I don't like much, but she likes this one. It's already a tube top, but I don't know that the fringe here, or this lace or whatever this is called, it just kind of doesn't match the idea or of the costume. So yeah, I have, let me see, in the future I also have to make some costumes, like the tunics that Indians wear. with the, what are they called? The scarf and the, I have to jewel it up and bling it up. And I'm not sure that I can do that one on video because those probably would be very long. But I'll give it a try, and if it comes out, hey, you know, it's something I like creating, I like crafting, I like sewing, I like, those are my favorite things I love to do, drawing, crafting, sewing, all that stuff is just so, it's one of my passions. So, hope you enjoyed this video, and I'll see you next time. Don't forget to subscribe if you like my videos. Thank you. Bye.